Hi all, welcome back to the Power Electronics and Instrumentation class. So here in this module today, we were discussing about module 3. So let's continue with the multi-range ammeters. So we know that the basic components for an electrical circuit is the currents and the voltage. That the currents flowing in the circuit and the voltage that is the voltage drop that is available across the different load elements in a circuit, right? So here the basic parameters are voltage and current. So we will have a detailed discussion about the devices which we use to measure this voltage and current. Okay, so we know that the device ammeter, okay, this device for which we are going to use, we are going to use ammeters to find out the value of the current flowing in the circuit. I hope all of you know this, right? Ammeters, you might have used it. Next, similarly, voltmeters. So voltmeters means these are the instruments, measuring instruments, which we use to measure the voltage in a circuit. Isn't it very simple, right? So what is the difference between a galvanometer and an ammeter? So you might have heard about the term galvanometer, right? So what is the difference between a galvanometer and an ammeter? Yes, so ammeter finds out what is the value of the current flowing in the circuit, whereas a galvanometer just detects the presence of current. Okay, whether there is a flow of current in a circuit, that detection of the current, of the presence of current, is done by an instrument known as galvanometer. Whereas ammeter measures the by numbers what is the actual value of current flowing in a circuit. That is the difference between an ammeter and a galvanometer. Okay, so now to understand the basic working of an ammeter, let us consider a DC ammeter. Okay, so DC ammeter makes use of PMMC galvanometer. That is, the basic concepts of the PMMC galvanometer is used, and in this galvanometer we are making a slight change and we are going to make use of it as an ammeter. Okay, so what is this PMMC? Yes, it is nothing but permanent magnet moving coil galvanometer. So permanent magnets will be fixed and there will be a moving coil, and that setup is known as the that setup where it detects the presence of current. Such type of galvanometers are known as the PMMC galvanometers, which follows the principles of D'Arsonval's movement. In order to understand the working of an ammeter and the working of a voltmeter, so we need to understand this concept that is known as D'Arsonval's movement. Okay, so D'Arsonval's movement is nothing but the principle that is adapted in the PMMC type of galvanometer. First, we will understand what is this movement. Okay, so we know that, let us consider a north pole of the magnet and we are using a south pole of the magnet here. Okay, let us consider we are bringing two magnets, north pole and south pole of a magnet. So we know that whenever there are unlike charges or unlike poles together, then what happens? There will be magnetic lines of force. It is going to get attracted, right? So there will be magnetic lines of force. So we know that always the flux lines or the magnetic lines of force always flows from the north pole to the south pole of the magnet. right? So there is a magnetic field that is established between a north pole and south pole. So you know the basic of this. So this is nothing but the north pole and south pole. The magnets what you are using are known as the permanent magnets. Now what is the next point? Moving coil. So let us consider we are going to take a coil present here. Okay, or it can be, either it can be, the position can be a straight line or it can be a slant line or left slant or right slant. Okay, let us consider a coil is being placed within this magnetic field. So what will happen now? And let us assume that we are going to connect the coil to a current. So what happens? Whenever there is a conductor carrying current coil placed in a magnetic field, there will be some, yes, very good, there will be some EMF that will be generated. Okay, and this coil starts its deflecting action. Why the deflecting action? Magnetic field, which is having some force, current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field. So Faraday's law comes into picture here and the coil starts moving. Okay, so let us consider that this is the moving coil we have connected. So permanent magnet means north and south poles of the magnet. A moving coil setup is there. So if this moving coil is being connected to a pointer with some scale reading, okay, let us say this is some scale we are connecting to it. Okay, so the moving coil which deflects in this direction, okay, or moves in this direction, the pointer points to the scale, whatever the type of scale we are connecting to find out the presence of the current here, that shows the deflection. That deflection shows whether there is a current or not in the circuit. Okay, so this is the basic principle that is known as the D'Arsonval's movement. So in order to study about the DC ammeter, we are going to make use of this D'Arsonval movement. I hope you have understood what is this D'Arsonval's movement. Okay, so this, by making use of this principle, we are going to find out the working of a DC ammeter. First, we will study about a DC ammeter for one single coil. Now, you can see here, if you are connecting one single coil, okay, which is a very small one and light in weight, then it has a capacity of determining a small current. Now, if you want to find out a large current flowing, then you have to bypass the current through a set of resistors. Okay, then you will get the larger value of current. Okay, so this bypassing or the bypassing of the current using such resistances are known as the shunt. If you want to measure the current for very small current, you can use one single coil, okay, which is very light in weight and small. Whereas if you want to measure large values of current, we always bypass the major current flowing in the circuit through a set of or series of or resistors. Such type of resistors are known as shunt. Okay, so by making use of these principles, let us analyze the working of a DC ammeter. Now, let us consider a basic DC ammeter. Okay, so this is the representation of a basic DC ammeter. Okay, so here, as I said previously, to bypass a large current through a resistance, that resistance known as shunt is connected to the D'Arsonval, okay, or it's connected to the galvanometer, PMMC galvanometer. By making use of the principles of D'Arsonval movement, we are going to find out how we are going to calculate the current in the circuit. Okay, so now let us assume that some total current I, which is nothing but a combination of the shunt plus the combination of the movement, Okay, so this current flowing I is the ISH. The current flowing through the shunt resistance is known as the shunt current. Okay, then the current flowing through the movement, okay, or the galvanometer is known as the IM. So this IM is the full scale deflecting current of the movement. RM is the resistance, internal resistance of the movement. RSH is the shunt resistance. ISH is the shunt current. And I is the total current flowing. That is nothing but ISH plus IM. So, with this, let us analyze how we are going to find out what should be the resistance. By simply applying the circuit concepts or circuit theory, we can calculate what is the value of this RSH. Okay, so now let us analyze the circuit. Now, when you see the circuit, it is a parallel combination. Yes, so RSH is in parallel with RM. So, can we write it as the shunt resistance is in parallel with the resistance of the movement? Okay, next, when the resistors are in parallel, what happens to the voltage? Voltage across this limb and voltage across this limb, this remains the same. That is the principle of a parallel circuit. Can we write the voltage across the shunt is equal to the voltage developed at the moment? Yes. So, how can we write this VSH? Can I represent the voltage drop across this shunt resistors as I into R? Ohm's law. So, ISH into RSH gives the value of the voltage drop across the shunt. Do you agree? Next, RM is also similar kind. I into RM is nothing but the voltage developed at the moment. Okay. So, now VSH is nothing but ISH into RSH, and VM can also be written as IM into RM. Now, what are we interested in finding out? We are interested in calculating the shunt resistance. Okay. So, can we write the equation in terms of shunt resistance RSH? That is given as rewriting this or rearranging this equation. We are going to get IM into RM divided by ISH. Again, shunt, this is the part which we are going to use to find out the current that is flowing in the circuit. Okay, so we are designing it. So, can you also use the equation of I and write this ISH in terms of I? So, we know that by the circuit, can we say the total current flowing is equal to sum of the branch currents? So, the two branches are the shunt branch and the branch of the moment. Okay, the galvanometer that we are going to connect. Isn't it? So, ISH plus IM. So, can you write this equation in terms of ISH? Okay, let us call this as equation 1 and let us call this as equation number 2. Now, can we rewrite equation 2 in terms of ISH? Yes. So, ISH is equal to, bring this IM to the other side of the equation, you will get it as I minus IM. So, ISH is equal to I minus IM. Can you replace this equation? Call this as equation number 3. Can you rewrite equation 3, substituting equation 3 in equation 1? So, substituting in equation 3 in equation 1, what are we going to get? Let me write it as substituting equation 3 in equation 1. What do we get when we substitute? RSH is equal to IM into RM divided by I minus IM. So, this is the value we are going to use in order to find out the resistance of the shunt that is going to be connected across the galvanometer. So, by making use of this, we are going to find out the working principle of an ammeter, or ammeter works on this principle. Okay, once you know the resistance, you can find out directly what is the shunt current. Okay, or the current flowing in the circuit. Okay, so this is a basic principle. There are different conditions for choosing this shunt resistance. Let us one by one see what are the different conditions, how we can choose the value of the resistance that is being connected as a shunt in case of a DC ammeter. Usually we can make use of copper wires, but we prefer making use of constantin and magnesium as the materials for this type of shunt resistance. Okay, let's see the different parameters for connecting the shunt resistance. So these are some of the requirements while choosing a shunt for a DC ammeter. So some of the general requirements are: the temperature coefficient of shunt and the instrument should be low. The temperature coefficient should be low and it can be nearly identical. Okay, the first point. Then next, the resistance of the shunt should not vary with time. Okay, so the resistance should not vary with time. That is the next criteria that is required for connecting a shunt in a DC ammeter. It should carry current without excessive temperature rise. So the resistance, the shunt what we are connecting, must carry the current without the temperature rise. Okay, next, it should have a low thermal EMF. So we know that it is working on the principle of magnetic principles. That is, when you are connecting a coil, you have a magnetic field, you are moving the coil, there is some deflection, we are using a scale and finding out the presence of current. Okay, so that entire process is nothing but the production of EMF in a circuit. Okay, so it should have a low thermal EMF. So this is also one of the main reason why we don't prefer a copper wire while connecting a shunt resistance. Okay, so we prefer two materials which has a very low thermal EMF as well as a very low resistance. So that material is known as manganin. Compared to copper, we prefer to make use of manganin because it is having a very low thermal EMF as well as a low resistance, and usually this is used as a shunt in a DC ammeter for DC instruments. Manganin is the material that we are going to select for making use of this as a shunt in case of the DC instruments. Okay, whereas make use of constantin material as a shunt in case of AC instruments. Okay, constantin is having a high thermal EMF when compared to the manganin. Okay, manganin. So these two are the materials which is being used as a shunt when we are speaking with respect to the DC ammeters. Is it clear? Have you followed? Both of them have very low resistance when compared with copper. Okay, so for DC instruments, we make use of low thermal EMF material, that is manganin, and for a high thermal EMF material is constantin, which is used as the shunt for the different AC instruments. Okay, as well as, so in the case of constantin, being unidirectional is ineffective because AC we know is nothing but a bidirectional circuit. Since this circuit, the manganin as compared to the constantin, here the unidirectional effect cannot be used in case of goods. That is why we prefer the constantin. Okay. Now, if suppose we are going to use for a low current, okay, the casing will be placed within the circuit by meter casing. Whereas for currents above 200 ampere, the shunts will be separately mounted. Okay. Values will be done as a meter casing, whereas for currents above 200 ampere, it will be mounted separately. So this is how we are going to make use of shunt in a DC ammeter. So these are some of the basic principles or ideas which we have to know before we start the discussion of multi-range ammeters. Okay, this was only the basics of an DC ammeter as well as the shunt. Okay, now we will see in detail about the multi-range. Next, we will discuss about the multi-range ammeters. So, the multi-range ammeters, so already we have discussed about the DC ammeters. Okay, so here in this case of a DC ammeter, when we are going to use several shunts, okay, let us say R1, R2, R3, R4, okay. So, when we are using several shunts connected together by making use of a multi-range switch, such type of connection or such type of circuit is known as the multi-range ammeter circuits. Okay? So, here what happens is this switch, multi-position switch, S is known as the multi-position switch. Plays a important role, which is having a low contact resistance and it will be having a high current flowing capacity or high current handling capacity resistors, as well as the other conditions which we saw previously for a shunt, all those has to be satisfied. Only then we can make use of those type of resistors together to form a multi-range ammeter. Now, why this multi-range ammeter is preferred or is being used is, now whenever we use the previous one single DC ammeter, we can measure only up to certain value. Say, for example, the currents up to say 1 milliampere, from 0 to 1 milliampere you can measure. If you want to measure the currents in microamps, milliamps and then amps, then we use this type of multi-range ammeters. Okay. So, what happens in this case is this multi-position switch, whatever we are going to use here, changes or switches the range depending on where we are going to place it or what is the level of current we are going to assume that is being flowing into the circuit. Okay, so this multi-position switch works on the principle known as the make before break. Make before break principle means, now already it is positioned to the resistance range or the shunt range of R2. Now it has to go to R3. Then the specialty of such multi-position switches, before, that is, it has to make the next, it has to change the range from R2 to R3. Okay. Now what happens while changing the range from R2 to R3? First it will make a contact with R3 and then it will break the contact with R2, because high currents will be flowing here, and if suppose there is an open circuit, then you can imagine the damage that is being caused in the ammeters. Okay, so for that reason we are using the special type of switches known as make before break. Make before break means before breaking the contact with the previous range, first you make the circuit, first you rig up the circuit, or first you get connected to the next range of shunts. Okay, so if suppose you want to go to R3, you want to connect or change the range from R2 to R3, first you are going to get connected to R3, then it is going to break the connection that was previously done with respect to R2. So this type of switch is nothing but a multi-positional switch, that is known as the, which works on the principle of make before break. Okay, so the principle adopted is the same. The currents flowing here will be calculated by making use of the D'Arsonval movement. The principle of operation will also be the same. Okay, now while selecting the range, first you have to go from the highest one. Okay, so this type of multi-range ammeters can be used up to 50 amperes to measure the currents. Up to 50 amperes you can make use of multi-range ammeters, and when you are using this multi-range ammeters, one special care has to be taken such that from the highest value you have to keep on decreasing to the lowest value. Okay, so highest value, first you take the highest current range, then decrease it to the lowest range. This is how you have to operate a multi-range ammeter. You have understood the DC ammeters as well as the multi-range ammeters. We will solve few problems related to these and then we will move on to the voltmeters, multi-range voltmeters. Next let's go to the problems. So the first problem based on the DC ammeters, the statement goes like this: a 1 milliammeter meter movement. So 1 milliammeter meter movement is, meter movement means the D'Arsonval movements. Okay, so he is specifying the meter's current. Okay, the movement's current. So this will be, what will be the value here? Let us write the solution. First, let us write the given data, which says that a 1 milliampere meter movement with an internal resistance of 100 ohm is to be converted into a 0 to 100 milliampere. Okay, calculate the value of shunt resistance required. So you can understand that you have to find out the value of RSH. Okay, what is the given data now? Meter movement. Meter movement means it is nothing but movement specifies the D'Arsonval movement. So the current flowing in the movement is nothing but, you can write it down as 1 milliampere. Getting it? So with an internal resistance, the movement's internal resistance, movement's internal resistance is nothing but Rm, is specified as 100 ohm, is to be converted into a, so using this movement, the D'Arsonval movement, you have to convert it into a full scale reading of 100 milliammeter. From 0 to 100 milliammeter is the range. Okay, so full scale reading means the highest value you have to take. So the full scale reading, the total full scale reading is nothing but 100 milliamperes I. Okay, calculate the value of shunt resistance, RSH. So we already know the equation for finding out the RSH. So RSH is equal to, what does the equation say? Im into Rm divided by the total full scale deflection of the full current flowing in it minus Im. So can you substitute and tell us what is the answer you are getting? Okay, so RSH, Im is equal to 1 milli. You have to consider milli also. Milli, micro, whatever the range is given, consider that unit also. Okay, so 1 milli into 100 ohm divided by 100 milli minus 1 milli. So what value you are going to get will be your RSH. Write the unit in. Write the unit, if it is resistance, the unit is ohms. So what is the value you are going to get? Simple calculation. So you will be getting 1.01 ohms. Let us now solve the next type of problem depending on the multi-range ammeters. Okay, the first one was based on the DC ammeter. Now we will solve for a multi-range ammeters. Okay. So the problem states that design a multi-range ammeter with the range of 0 to 1 ampere, 5 ampere and 10 amperes. So three different ranges you have to find out. You can write it as 0 to 1, 0 to 5 and 0 to 10. Okay. It is in amperes. Okay. Employing individual shunt in each. So you have to employ individual shunt in each range. Okay. Are you getting an idea of the circuit, what you have studied and the problem, what you are going to solve? Design a multi-range ammeter for the different ranges. 0 to 1 ampere is one range. 0 to 5 amperes is the next range. 0 to 10 amperes is the third range. Employing individual shunt in each. So you have to substitute an individual shunt. or to find out the value of the shunt resistance. Full stop. A de-Arsenault movement with an internal resistance of 500 ohm and a full scale deflection of 10 milliamperes is available. So the de-Arsenault movement he is specifying, Rm is 500, Im is 10 milliampere. So first write the given data. So it says that given Rm is equal to 500 ohms, okay. What about Im? Full scale deflection of the movement is equal to 10 milliampere. Okay. While solving, you already know the formula. What's the formula? To find out the value of RSH, you have to use Im into Rm divided by I minus Im. This is the formula what you are going to use. Now, before you start solving the problem, first you have to know one thing. When you are using the units, if the value of Im is in milliamperes, whatever you are going to have here, convert that range also to milliamperes. Can you do that? How can you write 1 ampere? How can you write 1 ampere? 1000 milli. Milli means 10 raised to minus 3. Okay? Milli means 10 raised to minus 3. So, can you write 10 raised to plus 3 into 10 raised to minus 3? What is the value? It gives 1. So, for the first range, it is nothing but 1 ampere. Minus 3 plus 3 will be equal to 1 ampere. So, 10 to the power of 3, can you write it as 1, 2, 3 like this? 1000 milliamperes. Can you write it like this? So, like this, you have to first convert the units what you are subtracting as the same values. If it is microampere, convert this also into microampere. Then your simplification part becomes easier. Okay. Now, use the formula. First, range by range. One single range at a time. Take it, solve that, find out the shunt value what you have to connect. Okay. First value. So, for 0 to 1 ampere range, you should find out the shunt. So, 0 to 1 ampere means, can you write it as 1000 milliamperes? As I have already shown here, 1000 milliamperes, can you write? Yes. So, use this formula. 1000 milliampere is nothing but I. The range that is given, 0 to 1 ampere, the full scale reading, total current flowing in the shunt circuit, ammeter circuit is 1000 milliampere. Okay. Now, RSH for the first range. So, Im is given as 10 milli into RSH, Rm is given as 500 ohm divided by 1000 minus 10 milli. Is the substitution easy now? So, calculate and find out what is the value of RSH1. Similarly, for the next range, 0 to 5 amperes. Now, how you are going to write from 0 to 5 amperes? What will be the value you are going to take? 1 ampere is equal to 1000. Multiply by 5, you will get it as 5000. So, can you write it as 5000 milliamperes? Yes. So, use this as I. So, for the next range, 0 to 5, they have simply specified as 5. You can take the range as 0 to 5. That means the same, 5 amperes. Okay. So, next shunt value for the second range, if you want to calculate, you have to use 10 milli into 500 ohm divided by 5000 minus 10 milli. Milli, milli will get cancelled. Substitute and tell me what is the answer. Similarly, for the third range, which is nothing but 0 to 10 amperes. So, what will be in case of milliampere? 10,000 milliamperes. You can directly take amperes, but while substituting it or subtracting, it will be difficult for you. Just you can directly, without using the calculator, you can solve the problem. Okay, for that and using like this. For the third shunt that we have to connect, you can take it as 10 milli into 500 divided by 10,000 minus 10 milli. So, find out what is the values, three different values. Since they have given three range, you are finding out three different values for shunt. If it was more, 6 range, then you should find 6 different shunts that you have to connect across a DC ammeter to get a multi-range ammeters. Now quickly tell the answers for RSH1, RSH2 and RSH3. Check whether you have got the same answers. First shunt 5 ohms, second shunt 1 ohm, the third shunt is 0.05 ohms. So these are the shunt resistors that you have to connect to get a multi-range ammeter with these specifications. Have you understood how to find out the values of the different ranges of shunt and specify how it works as a multi-range ammeter? Okay. Next, these are the types of problem. You can solve few more problems on this type of multi-range ammeters. So the next topic that we are going to discuss under module 3 is multi-range voltmeters. So first, before we go in detail with respect to the multi-range voltmeters, first we will discuss about the DC voltmeters. Okay. First we will discuss about DC voltmeters. So, D-Arsenault movement or the PMMC galvanometer can be simply converted into a voltmeter by making use of a series or by multiplying a resistance in series, or such type of resistors is known as a multiplier. So, basic DC voltmeter circuit is current flowing IM. This is nothing but D-Arsenault movement. Okay, for this simply if you use a multiplier, this resistor is known as a multiplier. We are applying, let us say, RS series resistor. Okay. So, by just using this, we can convert it into the DC voltmeter. Of this multiplier is to limit the current flowing such that it should not go away from the full scale deflection of the movement. That is why we are using a multiplier to limit the flow of current into the circuit. Okay. So, by applying the circuit theory, we can also write it as V, the voltage applied is equal to, what is the current flowing? The current, let us consider it as IM, total current flow in the circuit. Because it is a series combination, the resistors are in series, hence the current flowing will be the same. So can we write IS is equal to RS plus RM directly? Yes. So we are interested in finding out what is the value of RS. So can we directly substitute this V by IM is equal to RS plus RM? Right? So, you are interested in finding out what is the value of the multiplier that you are using in a D-Arsenault movement to get a voltmeter. So, can we write the equation for finding out the multiplier resistance or the series resistance RS is equal to V by IM minus RM. Bring this RM to the other side, you are going to get the value of the multiplier resistance. So, as simple as that, this is the way which we are going to use a voltmeter by making use of D-Arsenault movement. Now, if you want to connect a multi-range voltmeter, then what you are going to do? You are going to connect to get a wide range of the values, you are going to connect different values of the multiplier to the D-Arsenault movement. In this case, you will get a multi-range voltmeter. So next we will see the figure 4. This is the basic DC voltmeter. Now we are going to find out a multi-range voltmeter. Different multipliers together, which gives a large number of workable ranges. So, we prefer a multi-range voltmeter. You can connect it in this fashion, okay? And then you have another method. This is a simple multi-range voltmeter, but usually we use the other type trivial method of the multi-range voltmeter, we can use the resistors or the multipliers connected in series string. Multipliers in series string. Okay, so this is the same way, but the representation is in the form of a series string. This method is preferred over this method because here R1, R2 and R3, we can use the standard precision multipliers which are already available of the same value. Only the designing part for the first resistor, okay, has to be done. Okay, the remaining how many ever resistors you want, that can be connected in series by making use of a standard available resistance. So that is the advantage of this type of connection when compared to the basic or trivial multi-range voltmeter method. Okay, so we will solve few problems on this. Solve a problem on the multi-range voltmeter. The statement goes like this: a D Arsenwall movement with a full scale deflection current of 50 microamperes, that is this movement's current IM is 50 microamperes, and internal resistance of the movement, that is 500 ohm, okay, is to be converted into a multi-range voltmeter. So this Arsenwall movement specification has to be converted into a multi-range voltmeter. So for the solution, first write down what is the value of current IM, 50 microamperes. Internal resistance RM is equal to 500 ohm. Determine the value of multipliers. So here in case of voltmeter, the resistance, the series resistance is known as the multiplier for the different range, 0 to 20, 0 to 50, 0 to 100 volts. Okay. So here again you have 20 volt. Okay. So there is no need of writing, you can directly use the formula now. For the first case, 0 to 20 volt. Okay, what is the value of voltage? That is equal to 20 volt. What is the formula we can use? To find out RS, V by IM minus RM. This is the formula which you can use, right? So V by IM minus RM, V is 20, IM is 50 micro minus RM is 500 ohms. Okay, you can convert this 500 ohms into micro or 10 to the power of 6 mega, so such that the calculation will become easier for you. So find out the value of RS. Similarly, for the first range, 0 to 20 volt, this is the value. Next range, that is 0 to 50 volts. So the value of V is equal to 50. To calculate, let us say this is RS1, the multiplier 1. So the multiplier 2 is equal to V is 50 volt divided by IM is 50 microampere minus 500 ohm will give you the value of the second range of the multiplier, RS2. Next, for the range of 0 to 100 volt, RS3 will be equal to 100 divided by 50 micro minus 500. So when you solve this, you will be getting the different values of the multipliers. So these will be the values of the multipliers that you have to connect in order to get a multi-range voltmeter with the specification of this D Arsenwall movement. Quickly find out the values and tell me one by one what is the values of RS1, RS2 and RS3. You have got the same answers. RS1 is 399.5 kilo ohm, RS2 is 999.5 kilo ohm and RS3 is 1999.5 kilo ohms. Okay, as you observe, we have in the beginning of the discussion about a DC voltmeter, we discussed about the multiplier which we are using to limit the flow of current. To limit the flow of current means what should be the value of the resistance? It should be a high value because you are limiting the current. If resistance is high, the current flow will be very less. Okay, so to limit the current, you can see the values kilo ohms. Okay, high value of resistors, that is how we are limiting the current through the circuit. Okay, so these are the different values of the multipliers that we can use for a multi-range voltmeter to get the values specified here. Okay, you can solve few more problems. Okay, and this completes the module 3, the basic principles of measurement, the multi-range voltmeters as well as the multi-range ammeters. Thank you.